Yeah, so don't stand underneath there. So, anyway, I cleared out the chandelier as well as this. Ooh, there's some coinage here that you might want to take a look at and shake this pot around. Oh, and I should add that whatever you see, like, if I find something in, like, one of these random pots, doesn't mean that you will. There's, like, a 50-50 shot at finding something in a room that you can shake, basically. So anyway, to clean up this room and pull this off of here, to get the ghosts to come out of this room, you have to exterminate those lights up there, I should say those flames up there. But what I'm gonna do first is loot this room if I can. So I'm just gonna open up this thing. There's nothing there, that's too bad. Come on, man, I need some moolah! And this is, as I said, definitely something that you want to do if you want to A-rank this game. So that is definitely what I'm gonna be doing. And I just exterminated them accidentally, but okay. Oh, I'm sorry for exterminating your candles, and yeah, they are dangerous, but I can handle them because I got the Poltergust 3000. Oh, no, I'm not. You guys are all going down. Little Redcap, are you referring to my brother Mario? Probably. So anyway, here we go! First, well, Luigi is, that's for certain. Here we go! Come on, a bunch of ghosts will pop out. Woo! And, yeah, you know how to take care of the ghosts by now. These are the jabbers, they're the most basic kind of ghosts. Oh, I got a heart from them, that was pretty nice. And there we go! Pull them in. And you'll notice, whenever a room is dark, Luigi will kind of hum the music very tentatively, like he's very, very nervous about it. But if a room is clear and it's light, you'll notice that he's very happy. Listen. He'll whistle it. And open this treasure chest, and a key will pop out. Boink! Grab that key, and it's the key to the door that's just to your right over there. You'll check your map over there, which I should actually show you. If you press the Y button, it'll go to your map, and this is very, very handy in order to find where you're supposed to go next. This mansion is pretty dang big, and I'm going to be covering every single room of it. Awesome sauce! The next one, I believe, is the wardrobe, if I'm not mistaken. And there is... No, wait, this isn't the wardrobe. The next room is the wardrobe. But, excuse me. But the wardrobe is coming up, but what I'm going to be explaining in there is blue ghosts. That's a new ghost. What are their names? I kind of forgot. I'll have to look that up later or put an annotation or something up on the screen. The blue ghosts that are upcoming, they hold a lot of cash, and there's only 15 of them in the game. If you miss your opportunity, you won't be able to get them again until a later chapter in this game, or I should say a later story point in this game, or area of the game, they call them. And that ghost had some moolah. So anyway, as I said before, loot all the rooms you can. Oh, by the way, once you get water later in the game, yes, you'll get water equipped to your vacuum. You'll be able to water plants like those. That gold bar that I got there was worth 100,000 grand. Or I should say $100,000. Oh, I just remembered the name of that other ghost. They're called a basher. And I should also add that, remember that I said you can angle your vacuum with the C-stick? Pull up on it and shake those chandeliers and see what comes out of it. And you might be able to get something... No, okay. I could use that heart since I kind of took a little damage there because I made a mistake getting the ghost there. Okay, this is the wardrobe room. Now, what you want to do is look for a blue ghost in this room. Now, the trick to these blue ghosts is that you have to get them before the room is cleared. Otherwise, they will. Otherwise, they won't appear. And they're very, very fast, as you can see there. You know what I'm gonna do is leave the room, then come back, which will reset the blue ghost position. As long as you don't make it, like, there we go, like that. As long as you don't make it disappear accidentally with your flashlight, you can still try again with the blue ghost. But if you do that, you've lost your chance at the blue ghost. As you can see, the blue ghosts can contain a lot of loot, so you definitely want to seek them out. There's also another concept coming up called mice, or I should say golden mice. Those green ghosts are called banana tossers, as you can see by their name. they toss bananas. If you ever run across a banana, you fall and you take damage. It's pretty simple. That's their only means of attack, basically. And I'll just show you what happens. Whee! And you also lose some coinage. So I definitely recommend that you collect your coins if you do lose any coins. And one more ghost to go. Suck up that banana. And if you ever want to get rid of the bananas, just suck them up. I do recommend that you do that because they will get in your way. But sometimes you don't have the opportunity to do so because of the other ghosts in the room. And there should be more coming here. Or do I have to shake this? Oh, money, 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 looting, yeah! What's in here? It's a ghost! And there we go. The reason why you want to get close to a ghost before you move your flashlight over it is because it stuns them longer than if you were to touch them with your flashlight beam from a distance. Well, you'll notice that there's a key up there and you can't seem to get to it. Oh, there's a mirror here if you want to warp back to the foyer. But anyway, what you want to do here is get your vacuum and suck it down by angling upwards with the C-stick. And there's your key, which will be the key to the room that's to the left of you. I should say not to the left of you, it's back to that foyer room. But what you want to do first is go over to here and comfort this toad here, which will clear the room. Oh, wait, you're actually happy to find me? I guess this was back before, they didn't know about Luigi. Did you notice that in later games, they just seem to shun Luigi as sort of an inside joke? Like, they don't seem to know who he is, or that he's a loser, or something like that. You'll see that referenced many times in the Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga games, because of the fact that the fans want to see more games with Luigi in it. And he's a very neglected character, they're basically saying. But they're putting him in a lot more games nowadays and making him more playable. So I guess that he's slowly losing that image. But the in-joke still stays. Anyway, go back to this room here. Well, not this room exactly. Wait. I forgot to shake down the chandelier here, didn't I? Can I get something from it? Can I get something? Whoa, no! I'll demonstrate this. If you ever get hit by a poison mushroom, you shrink in size, and you lose the ability to use your vacuum. So that gets in the way of when you're trying to get ghosts. And you also can't open doors, you can't escape rooms either, but you eventually turn back to normal size on your own. Now let's see if there's anything... Oh, I get a little message when I approach this door by EGAD here. And the spirit's stronger, it must be the portrait ghosts. Well, he calls them gallery ghosts, but I always call them portrait ghosts. And he tells you that the best way to figure out their weakness is to examine them with the Game Boy Horror and then press the X button. But the thing is with that is that they don't usually tell you their weakness. Oh, and the reason why I'm checking these vases again is because, remember that I said that you can find things if you loot rooms by shaking things around or hitting them with the vacuum? Well, sometimes there's like a 50-50 shot of finding things in those areas, but once you find something in a hidden spot, you'll never find something from that spot again. That's basically the thing about it. Oh, and if you open this door with a coin's lead, you're gonna take damage. Yeah, that's a fake door. You gotta look out for fake doors like that in this game because you lose some money. But the easiest way to figure out how to get rid of, or I should say figure out which doors are fake or not, is to check your map. Like if you look here, you'll notice that there's blank doors, or I should say there's no, there's a wall behind where this would be if you check the map, if you stand right in front of it. See where Luigi's head is on the map? And then there's another fake door here. There's a lot of fake doors here, if I'm not mistaken, in general. And there's mice all over the place. They don't give you anything. Oh, as I was saying about looting things, you have a 50-50 shot of finding it. If you don't find it your first try, if you go far enough away from a spot, you'll be able to find it again. If you're lucky, look out for that book. You can suck in that book if you want to. This is the first portrait ghost. He's kind of spooky there. I'm trying to... There we go. Thank you very much. This first portrait ghost here, every portrait ghost has a weakness, and you have to figure out what that weakness is. But the first thing that I'm going to do here is, because you can't find blue ghosts or golden mice in a cleared room, which is a light room, You have to find them when it's dark, like this. So make sure you clear out the room as much as you can, but don't try to clear the room, basically. Like if there's any stray jabber ghost or something like that. Oh, I just exposed his weakness accidentally there. If there's any stray ghost there, leave them and just scare them away, and then try and find the blue ghost, which is right here. Like that, and suck him in for a whole load of loot. Woo! And the rubies here are worth quite a lot. I'm trying to suck... Come on, get... There we go. I was wondering if that thing would get sucked in eventually. I should catch up. I should get this stuff in while I can before it disappears. Rubies are worth a million in money, so you definitely want to get those rubies. There's also a sapphire that looks exactly the same, but it's green. It's worth 800,000, and blue one... An emerald is worth 800,000, and the emeralds are green, of course, and the blue sapphires are worth 500,000. Anyway, another thing, another concept here, is there are golden mice here. There are two kinds of golden mice. When you look for cheese in a room, like there's a piece of cheese in the study here, there's 10 golden mice, 5 cheese mice, and 5 random mice. When you examine cheese like this, you'll find a golden mice that pops out of it, and what you want to do is hurry up and suck it in, and it'll also give you a load of loot. There's an emerald. Awesome. Unlike the blue ghosts, despite there being only 10, and they give you more money than blue ghosts, typically, you have unlimited tries to get a gold mouse. Now, the random gold mice that you can find later appear when you walk across a specific point in a room. And you only have a 20% chance of finding it each time you walk in a room. So what you have to do to find those random golden mice is walk in and out of a room and touch that spot until the golden mice appears, and then you have to suck it in. There's one gold mouse that I probably won't cover because it's really annoying to get, but I will make note of it. Anyway, here, now you'll notice this portrait ghost here. He's a very special ghost. When you defeat a portrait ghost like this, you add his picture to the gallery, and when you lower their health, what happens is they drop a pearl. Now, the beginning pearls aren't worth very much. The small pearls are worth 50,000 apiece. Well, I suppose that's worth quite a bit, actually, but for every 10 HP you drain it in a row, it drops a small pearl for 4 pearls. And then when you get down to the next 4, it drops medium-sized pearls, which are worth 100,000. And then if you manage to drop it by a full 90 points in one run without losing the ghost's hold, or losing your hold on the ghost, you'll get a ginormous large pearl, which is worth $1 million. So these portrait ghosts here are very much worth making sure that you can get them in one shot, but sometimes that just isn't possible, you know, just by the game's design. But I'll do my best to get as many pearls as I possibly can. Anyway, this guy's weakness is when he yawns, he is vulnerable to the flashlight, and then you can suck him in. Okay, there's one pearl. Every 10 HP, he drops a pearl. Try and get as many of them as you possibly can. I gotta get him down to 10 to get the big pearl. Yeah! First try, baby! Woo! And I'm gonna get his... Oh, shoot, I just lost some pocket change from getting hit by that poisonous mushroom there. Oh, well. And I also cleared the room by getting that portrait ghost. And open up this I can't open treasure chests when I'm small, my bad. Oh, yeah. So open up this, and you'll get a key to the next room.